What's up, guys? This is the Minister of Beauty. Thank you so much for joining me for another video. This is Business Mondays with the Minister of Beauty, and I share the Bible that is business, inspiration, beauty, life, and enjoyment. So I wanted to talk about something that I actually caught wind of when I was having a conversation with someone recently, and we were talking about manifesting what you desire to see happen in your business. And how important it is to be in the now in order to see it happen later, even if you don't feel it or see it, or, you know, it takes continual speaking of it in order to actually believe it. You have to get to that place of belief by continuing to speak it and act as if it has already occurred. Well, years ago, I started my business in 2008, and when I started my business, I started as a solo practitioner. I'm a licensed esthetician. And when I started renting a room in another business. And back then, I had come out of the legal field. I was a legal assistant for 12 years. And so I wasn't really sure where I was going with this. I just knew that there was something greater for me in the fact that I had made the bold steps and had the audacity to become an entrepreneur when no one in my family had ever been an entrepreneur. I didn't have a blueprint. I didn't have someone that I could, you know, emulate or copy. I don't want to say copy, but I didn't have anyone that I could emulate or just go to that I was familiar with or that I knew that I could ask questions of or that could help guide me. I did everything on my own, and thank God things worked out, because I just kind of flowed by the spirit within me, praying and asking God for direction, and things worked out over the years. And here we are, 2021, and I am still operating, and I've grown over those years. But when I started, I was renting this room. The salon that I was renting in, it honestly was not the best. It was not in a bad area, but the atmosphere was pretty toxic. The owner of the salon, she was pretty toxic. I didn't have anything personally against her. I didn't really even know her. This was all a business transaction for me, but I digress. I had the mindset of saying that this is going to be bigger than what it is right now. Yes, I'm just in this room in another salon. The name of the salon was what was on the marquee outside, not the name of the business that I would create, which I created my own business name, and I created my own website many years ago. And thinking back on that now, I'm like, oh my God, I actually made my own website, because I'm not a tech savvy person, but I did it, and it was actually pretty decent. I actually wish I had screenshots of what it was today that I created many years ago, but you know, that's done and over with. But I created my own website, and in order to do that, I needed to buy my domain name. So I said, well, this is going to be permanent. So I want to buy the domain name of what my business name is going to be, because this is going to be legit. This is going to be real. I'm going to have this registered with the state. This is going to be registered with the IRS and with the, you know, the state department and all of those different things. So this is going to be legit. This is going to be official. So I had the audacity and that mindset to create my business name, and I have the name Lounge in my business. Now, again, I was just renting a room in another business. So a room in another business that had another name of that actual business on the marquee outside, it's definitely not a lounge. It was a hair salon. But I said, this is what it's going to be. This is going to be official. This is going to be legit. So I need to do this the right way. So in order for me to do it the right way, I had to have that mindset where I was thinking future and not looking at what it is today. Because if I had that mindset of looking at what it is today, first and foremost, I probably would have never purchased a domain name and created a website. That's for sure. I probably would have just been looking at who is coming into that salon and promoting and marketing to those people and not thinking outside of the box, because I didn't promote or market to those people at all. I actually was like, this is going to be where I am now. I don't know how long I'm going to be here. And it actually turned out to be a lot less time than I thought it was going to be, but God had other plans. And I'm not going to make a video about that. I have a book that I've been writing for some time. It's not complete, but I will be writing about these experiences because I've been through a lot of crazy hell in this industry that I'm in and the business hoopla that I have experienced. But getting back to the topic at hand, I had the mindset to say, well, this is temporary. So what is the business name going to be? What is the domain name going to be? And so I put the word lounge in my business name at the end, because I said, well, this is what I am picturing. No, this room that I'm renting right now is not a lounge. No, this hair salon is not a lounge. This is what I am picturing. And so doing that all of those years ago, back in 2008, guys, I have had that experience over the years where I have seen the manifestation of what I set into motion come to pass. So I have had a number of different lounges, a number of different beauty lounges for my business. And back then when I was starting, I actually was nervous. I was like, this is new to me. I'm leaving a field that I was in for 12 years. Although unhappy in it, I was familiar with it. I was used to it. This, something completely and totally different, something completely and totally new. So I can't say that I wasn't nervous or I wasn't scared. I absolutely was, but I just moved forward in that fear and saw the manifestation of what I spoke happen. And the location that I'm in right now is a product of me putting that into motion all of those years ago by saying that I have a lounge. I have a beauty lounge, not just I'm renting a room in another, you know, person's business. And so I am saying all of those things to say, tongue twister. I am saying all of that to say, it is really important that you get a vision of what you want to have. And I do remember doing little sketches and writing things out all of those years ago. Is everything what I wrote out what it is today? No, absolutely not. But I did have a vision and I wrote things out. And I had the audacity to create that business name, buy that domain, create the website, register the business names with the business entities that I need to do that, and so that my business would be official. And indeed, it has come to pass. So we have to, if you see yourself as a millionaire, speak as if you already are. And don't just, you know, say, well, when I get my millions, I'm going to do this. Operate as if you already have it. And I know it's not easy. It is something that you have to practice. Practice makes perfect. We have to practice it. We have to practice anything in order for it to become a habit. So no, when you're broke as a joke and like your pockets are like completely empty, it's not easy to act as if you have money flowing and the bank accounts are filled and the, you know, the cash register or whatever you're using to ring up your products or services or whatever, you know, it is, your PayPal is blinging or whatever, and it's not doing that, but you have to speak as if it is. It is a practice to do that. So you have to practice doing that. You really have to. So when I was having a conversation with a friend and colleague about this a couple of weeks ago, I was like, yeah, that's actually what I did. I created the business name. I called it a beauty lounge, even though I was only renting a room in another person's business and I did not have a beauty lounge. That actually came 4 years later, because that was just the first place I rented a room, and I rented a room in several other businesses over the years until I got my first location, my own building. And then that happened in 2012. So I continued to speak it and I continued to operate in it. And when I was marketing and promoting my business, even though I was not in my own space, it didn't change the fact that I called my business the Beauty Lounge. So it does make a difference when you speak it into existence. It, you may not know exactly when it's going to happen, but if you believe it and if you operate in as if it has already occurred, it indeed will happen. So guys, I just wanted to encourage you with that, and I hope you can relate. If you can, let me know in the comments section. I really appreciate you guys liking, commenting, and subscribing. And I am Elizabeth, the Minister of Beauty, here to share the Bible. That is business, inspiration, beauty, life, and enjoyment. So enjoy your success. Enjoy manifesting what you want to see happen in your life, business and professional. You know, well, business and personal, I should say. Business is professional, I hope. So guys, until the next video, I really appreciate you all, and I hope you all have an amazingly blessed and beautiful day.